Who am I? I don't know.
Who am I? Who am I?
What's up, guys? So, because I'm doing lots more YouTube this year, I thought I should probably start with basically saying who I am. I mean, like, if you follow my Instagram, you probably have a pretty good idea of who I am, what I do, the kind of work I do. If you're new to my channel, then you probably have got no clue. I mean, who is this guy? So, yeah, I thought I'd go into a little bit of a background about me. So while I was at the clothes show just before Christmas, I got interviewed a couple of times, and I thought I'd kind of just basically replicate some of those questions and put them into this video. Unfortunately, I don't have the beautiful Antonio O'Brien to interview me on this occasion, so I'm just going to put little captions up probably, and we'll see how it goes. So, a little intro, kind of summary. I am a fashion photographer. I also shoot some celebrities. I have been doing photography as my full-time job for like 10 years now, and I love it. It's my passion. It's the best job in the world as far as I'm concerned. I get to travel the world, I get to meet amazing people, and 99% of the time I don't even consider it a real job. But yeah, I really do love it. Primarily, I shoot fashion. I also shoot a few celebrities. I've been published in magazines all over the world. I've worked with people like David Hasselhoff and Boyzone, McFly, Little Mix, Billy McIntosh, Laura Whitmore. So many people, and the list is getting longer and longer. You know, obviously, like most people, I've been published on the internet, but equally, I've had my work on like Oxford Street, like main high streets. I've had my work printed huge on the side of hotels. So a kind of history about how I got into photography. I suppose, unlike a lot of people, I didn't realize I was a photographer. I mean, I've always been a photographer. This is the funny thing. So I was first given a camera when I was, must have been 6 or 7 years old. I always wanted to play with mum and dad's camera on holidays and stuff like that. They would never let me. There was always a drawer, like in the living room, I had the camera and the film, and I wasn't allowed to touch it. So I got my first camera. It was like a tiny little film thing, 12 photos per roll of film. And I think, yeah, like you got like, if you wanted a flash, there was a flash that went on the top and it had like 4 bulbs in it. And yeah, literally you would take 4 photos with flash and that's it, you're done. You need to buy a new flash. Done, finished. I mean, that's ridiculous. Like, we're so lucky these days, like literally stuff just works. It works forever. So yeah, so that was my first camera and I loved that thing. I, you know, took it on holiday, took loads of photos on it. And obviously I was still kind of restricted to the film that mum and dad would buy me. So I progressed. When I was 16, my parents, who both worked in aviation, they offered me a choice for my 16th birthday of flying lessons or a camera. And I've been told on many occasions that flying lessons would have been the cool thing to choose. You know, to say, yeah, I can fly a plane. That would be awesome. But I chose a camera because that's kind of, yeah, that's who I am. That's what I wanted to do. Only I didn't realize that it was what I wanted to do. So yeah, so I got this camera and it was a SLR, but it was a APS SLR, which any photo geeks watching this are probably like, really, what? You had one of those? Weirdo. Yeah, and I loved that thing, and you know, I remember taking it to places like Barcelona and Paris, and I really found my love for photography then. I had 1 week of photography training when I was at art college. I failed because apparently I was using the wrong camera, so I failed through non-submission because my work was refused and rejected. So yeah, but you know, I do this as a job now, so clearly, what do they know? I did go to art college, basically ended up being a graphic designer. I got a degree in graphic design. All of my work though was so heavily photographic, like I was always looking for excuses to take pictures. The like in my layouts, the pictures were always the hero. My pictures were always the star. At no point did anyone say, "You're a photographer. Stop doing this design shit. you know, take pictures. That's who you are. Basically, worked for as a designer for 5 years. My last proper job was actually for a garden hose company, a multinational garden hose company. Yeah, I was designing packaging and brochures and stuff like that. And actually, I got hired for that job because I had a photography section in my design portfolio, also kind of irrelevant, but I was that into photos that I, you know, that's what I did. And my last proper boss was loved photography, so he actually hired me as a result of it. So basically, I had a year of working with him, talking about photography all the time, and, you know, and doing photography, like I'd do studio product shots and stuff like that. And we had this little studio behind our office, and basically, I ended up getting made redundant in 2006. Obviously, no one likes to get made redundant. You know, you lose your job. I didn't get much in the way of a payout because I'd only been there a year. And at the time, I felt like shit. It was like, oh my God, what am I going to do? I've got a rent to pay and I've got bills and all of this stuff. So, yeah, like, it wasn't great, but it was without doubt the best thing that ever happened to me in my life. The things I've done in my life since then and because that happened has been so amazing. So I got made redundant, did a couple of like freelance design things like fairly soon after, and then actually got offered a job working for a design company, like quite a big design company actually, and I turned it down. I was like, no, actually that's, no, I don't want to do that. I don't want to like sit in front of a computer all day, every day. I want to take pictures. So I made that decision, decided, oh crap, I need to learn about lighting and things. Yeah, I started listening to podcasts. I basically learnt photography off the internet. I mean, that's basically how I learned. But yeah, so I wanted to learn lighting. I looked up a couple of people like that did courses in my area. There was one guy, I emailed him, sent him some of my pictures and said, I really want to do a lighting course. Like, have you got anything coming up anytime soon? He actually replied with, let's meet up for a coffee. So we met up for a coffee and he said, you don't need to go on a course. I can teach you lighting in 20 minutes. Come to my studio next week. So I did. And he literally taught me everything I needed to know in 20 minutes. On the one hand, I was kind of like, wow, that was amazing. I've learned stuff. But it also changed this kind of mindset that photography isn't that hard. As long as you learn the basics and the fundamentals of what it is you're trying to do, then the rest you can just kind of work out. You can reverse engineer. And yeah, that had a big impact in the way I approach what I do, and also the way I approach helping others to do it as well. If someone says, how do you do this? I will tell them how to do it. Like, it's not a problem. But more fundamentally, I'll tell them how to work it out for themselves, because I think that's kind of just way more important. Also, like, way back in the day, yeah, there was this guy who said, the best way to get ahead is to help those around you to get ahead. And that kind of also stuck with me. So yeah, I'm big into helping people, and, you know, because I think the more you help other people and push them, then, you know, they push you back, and then it helps everyone to get better. So, and that can only be a good thing. 6 weeks after I had this 20-minute lighting course, I was helping him teach photography, which blew my mind a little bit. A couple of months after that, I'd shot my first magazine cover. It was a shitty trade magazine, but yeah, like, it was still an amazing thing to actually do in such a short space of time. Yeah, so my career has like really grown since then. I mean, like I said earlier, I've done so much amazing, so many amazing things, and I'm really thankful for some of the opportunities I've had. From obviously doing all the photography work, I've then also done various public speaking things. So I spoke at the clothes show a couple of months ago, and the photography show. I also occasionally do workshops and seminars when people are asking. I've done like Facebook Live things for Jessup's, and yeah, all of that kind of stuff. Like, it was always scary. It's a bit like doing YouTube. Like, I was always really apprehensive the first time I did a video. The first time I did a video on YouTube was in 2008. It's now set to private because it's so bad. I might put a clip here because Like, seriously, who wears a baseball cap sideways? The reason for wearing a baseball cap sideways is because if you have a flash here or a flash trigger, then it doesn't work. So, like that, yeah. But not in a video. Don't do it. It's just dumb. But anyway, hat wearing problems. The first time I thought, you know, did speaking on YouTube, like me talking, was actually kind of this time last year, and I was so nervous. I overthought it. I researched it. Like, I watched pretty much every YouTuber and every vlogger I could find, in order to kind of work out what the hell to do and how to be and do all that. Upshot is be yourself, but hey. So that, and then doing TPS, I was really nervous for that. But then once I was on the stage, I loved it. And doing the clothes show a couple of months ago, that was a major turning point. Like, I actually genuinely loved it. There was like no nerves. It was almost just normal, which was ridiculous. But yeah, like, I was on stage like a few times every day and just chatting to people and seeing tweets and hearing people come up to me afterwards and say like, wow, you're so inspiring. That was, gave me such a buzz that ultimately I kind of want to carry that on and kind of inspire more people. But yeah, so that speaking is something that I definitely want to do more, and I'm definitely enjoying doing that and progressing my career in that way. Also, a lot of you know, if you follow me on Instagram and Twitter and things like that, that I'm an Olympus ambassador. So I'm one of their pro photographer ambassadors. So I do the pro stuff, but I also straddle this line, and I work a lot with the influencers and the bloggers, and I help them, and I help them do workshops and help them do what they want to do better. Help them with their Instagrams and just improve their photography, working with the Olympus pen range a lot. So that again helps me kind of get better at teaching and imparting my wisdom onto the world. My favorite moments in my photography, there's two. Like, I always ask, like, what's your favorite? And there's two like standout ones. I mean, besides the kind of like the first time you see your work in print, or the first time you're walking down the street and you like see a poster and it's like, I did that. I mean, that's amazing. But I think, yeah, there was two. There was one occasion, we were doing this kind of PR advertising campaign job, like in conjunction with Amanda Wakely. And yeah, so we had this beautiful model who was ridiculously tall. Like, not just model tall, but tall model tall. So which her, and we had this beautiful outfits and long gowns and stuff like that, and a private jet. So the original plan, like the mood board, all of that, was to have her inside the private jet looking all glamorous and rich and that kind of thing. And she was so tall that when she stood up in heels, she couldn't, she was like this with the ceiling and that, yeah. That, so that really, really wasn't going to work. So we couldn't do it inside, so we had to move outside. And then we went outside with this private jet. And this moment that I will always cherish was when I looked at where the sun was and where this jet was, and I just said, can you move the jet round? And the guys went, okay. And yeah, just the ability to have a private jet moved because you just didn't like the way it was, I think is pretty special. I don't know if I'll ever get that again. So that's number one. That's like one of my favorite moments. The other one was, and I always like to set the scene on this one when people ask, is, so I was in my flat, in here, over there in my kitchen, and it was a Thursday night, kind of November Thursday night. It was cold, and I was cooking like this massive bat. I was cooking a bat. Don't cook bats. Maybe cook bat. I don't know. I've never eaten a bat. They might be lovely. Don't go and catch bats. Anyway, yeah. So I was cooking a vat of chili, like this huge, big pan of chili. So I'm sitting there stirring, and my phone rings. So I'm like, hello, and they're like, Jay, yeah, are you in town right now? Actually, I didn't answer it like that because I knew who the person was that was ringing me. So that's a lie. But yeah, so I was like, hi. So they're like, are you in town right now? I was like, yeah, what are you doing? I'm cooking chili. And for anyone that cares, my chili's awesome. Like really good. You should have my chili. I might do a recipe. I probably won't. Anyway, so yes, I was cooking chili and they're like, are you in town right now? I was like, yeah. Can you come down to Tower Bridge, to the banks of the Thames, and shoot the Hoff surrounded by zombies? okay. I kind of still can't actually understand the actual thing. David Hasselhoff had just released an iPhone game called Hoff Zombie Beach, and they needed press shots, and their photographer was stuck, couldn't make it, cancelled, I don't know, whatever, turned into a ghost, or a zombie, who knows. And yeah, so they needed someone, and Jay to save the day. So yeah, so I went down to Tower Bridge, and I shot David Hasselhoff in his Baywatch gear in front of Tower Bridge, surrounded by zombies. I couldn't have made up that story to be anywhere near as random as it actually was. It was one of the most obscure Thursday nights I ever had in my life. I literally went from cooking chili. I didn't even turn the chili off. I just turned it down. Down there, I was back home and cooking chili again within an hour. That's weird and mental. Those are my two kind of standout moments, the private jet and David Hasselhoff. That's basically me. And I hope that you feel that you've got to know me a little bit better. I mean, from a professional point of view. If you want to know more about my personal life, then you're nosy. But if you do want to know, then ask questions. Like, I'm pretty much an open book. Obviously, there are things I don't put on the internet, and you can ask. I will say, I'm not telling you. But yeah, beyond that, like, leave a comment down below, and I will see you in the next video.